So you guys remember the first generation's Moto G series phone and Moto E series phone? They were the first phone, you know, that gives the experience of the flagship level quality on the budget side. So they were the huge. After that, there are so many budget phones are coming around the 15,000, 20,000 rupees between that. So, but recently, I guess with the current generation's Moto G6 line of phone, the G6, G6 Plus, they were kind of flop because, you know, slightly expensive, not slightly, they are too much expensive. The processor was not great and software updates were kind of very slow. So they were just missing a lot of trend. So to fix that thing, Motorola brought their first Android One device. This is called as a Moto One Power, and like I said, this is the first Android One device, so there should not be any problem of getting software update. So guys, this is a 2 days review, and after such review with the pros and cons with the Motorola One Power, should you buy this device or not? I haven't posted the durability on this channel, but if you can understand Hindi, you can watch out my this durability in Hindi channel. Otherwise, for those who don't, you can watch in the visuals. Without hearing much, you can actually understand. So this phone seems to be very durable, it's still working fine. You can see, like all the usual tests we did, this phone is perfectly working. Scratch test, bend test, drop test, waterproof test, everywhere this phone is just survived. This phone is definitely, you know, I will say heavy. In my case, I'm used to it because my Galaxy Note 9 has a similar weight, around 205 gram. This is again 205 gram, but this is a more pocketable form factor. The rounded curved corners, which makes it easy to hold, and fingerprint sensor on the proper layout. So for me, it's not a big deal. Moto G6, it has the IPS LCD. This is the LTPS LCD. So technically, LTPS gives you more resolutions on the phone, but the overall lifespan of LTPS technology is lesser compared to the IPS. But I'm sure at least it's gonna last long for 3 to 4 years. That is the most you're going to use a budget phone. There is some problem with this display, like there's a display bleeding issue. So you won't notice that thing at all until, unless, for example, this is as of now on the settings, this is white. But once you open any application, say the Motorola, once it is gray, the navigation bar, you can see the light is bleeding from here, which I'm not able to see here on this display. You can see I'm not able to see anything here. This is completely black. There is no display bleeding here, but here you can see there's a display bleeding. So display quality is good. I'm using alongside other phones like the Redmi Note 5 Pro, Zenfone Max Pro M1 and the Mi A2. So it looks great. So this is the stock Android One device. Motorola has added few of the custom applications of their own, not too much. They have this few set of Moto application, not all of them, like the Moto display and the Moto action, chop chop to turn on the flashlight. These are the only feature. It has this you know, Motorola launcher, which will give you this Google Home feed if you're interested to those kinds of stuff. Just for a reference, these are the two devices, the Android One from the Xiaomi, and this is Motorola. If we just go to the about phone section, so this device is running the September 5, this is still running the August 1. It's already been 2 to 3 days, haven't got any software update or any kind of security update. This is October, my Pixel is on the October security patch. So don't expect Android One to be like the Pixel One to get the always on time experience. So they are kind of low, but rest assured, you're going to get the Android Pi and the Android 10 on this device too. That is guaranteed. This device comes with a Snapdragon 6 series. The 4 GB is the maximum option available. Hopefully in the future they will you know, make 6 GB also available. So far with the day-to-day usage, I'm not seeing the device is slow. It is faster because 6 GB is very popular processor. It's there in the so many phones, so it is good. But you know, when you see the complete the memory management, I tested that against some of the popular phones. So when trying to launch many application, the Mi A2, which also has the same 4 GB of RAM, Snapdragon 660, it is able to keep all the application in the memory, but the Moto One Power, it just failed to keep all the application in the memory. So this could be something Motorola has done internally, maybe adding their own Motorola software, the Moto display feature. So those things actually takes maybe a little bit of battery, or maybe inside some of the processor, some of the memory. That is why it is not keeping all the application in the memory. So if you are a casual user, it should be fine for you. I mean, launching a few set of applications like the 2-3 games or 4 to 5 social applications, those should be in the memory. But if you are a sort of heavy user, I guess 4 GB RAM variant is less for you. But since there is only 4 GB RAM variant available, so you should look for some other alternatives. Otherwise, for the casual user, this device is great. The performance is okay. I haven't felt like this is getting slow at all. This is just fine. Since these are the budget devices, you cannot really expect super high quality. And so far, I compared this phone against some of the popular phones. So I like this quality. I'm not saying this is the best in all of them, but really in most of the situations, I simply cannot deny that this is taking almost the same photos that other phones are taking. And some phases, especially like in the portrait, I prefer that phone because, you know, it just takes nice portrait. I have the control on the portrait. If you just go inside this portrait section, this is the camera and here is the portrait. You can control the depth level from 0 to 6, which is great. And it can film the 4K video, which is also nice. Some of these Snapdragon 6s phones, they have limitation of they can just fill in the full HD. And speaking of the video quality, this phone is just not too much stabilized. I don't know why this is not too much stabilized, so compared to other phones. But overall, the camera is good. If you just try to take photos on the low light, it is just okay. Not the best, not the super best, it's just fine. At least it is better than other of the rival segment, like, you know, Note 5 Pro, Gen 4 M1. It is doing better job than that. The main selling point for this phone, so far I am very impressed with the battery, because after a long time I have seen such a phone which gives such a great battery backup. So you can see my stats, 7 hour 41 minute going on of the screen on time, and still I got 30% of battery left. And definitely sure I'm going to make the next day. If you see my the usage detail, so down here you can see camera used for 1 hour 8 minute. I watched the YouTube video here for 30 minutes too, played some games too. This phone has a Dolby Atmos, but this time they moved the speaker to the bottom side. I really don't know why they moved this speaker, which is there on the front side, to the bottom side. The front side makes the experience better, but here it is okay, but it is very, very loud.
डिजाइन चेंज है, इस बार उन्होंने मेटल इंक्लूड किया है ओवर टू द ग्लास और प्लास्टिक जो भी यूज करते हैं, तो हम वेरीफाई करते हैं.
Obviously this phone has a USB type C. Out of the box it comes with a 18 watt fast charger, which is turbo power, and in roughly 2 hours you can exactly charge this phone. And this phone is officially IP52. That means you can easily throw it the phone for a splash test on the water for a couple of seconds. I tested for a minute inside my regular testing routine. It just works fine for me. Now those are some of the things that I'm going to tell you. Now some of the things I do notice on this phone is that fingerprint sensor is not very fast. It's not always accurate, since my fingerprint is already scratched. So could be the reason behind that. And here display bleeding issue is already there. And here inside the display, there is no such option like you can hide the notch. This is not there as of now. This is the manufacturer implementation. Hopefully in the future they should bring that feature to you. And regarding the HD playback on the Netflix, yes, you can play HD videos on the Netflix. I'm just showing you with my subscription the strangest thing. So if you just play, so right here you can see this is HD. It shows here it is in HD. You cannot play beyond than that. So you can easily play HD Netflix content here. And as of now, this dual 4G for this network is not supported. According to Motorola, that should come with the Android Pie. So in the Oreo, it is not yet enabled. You have to wait for that. There is no face unlock in this phone as of now, since this is stock Android, and stock Android doesn't offer the face unlock feature. Even the Pixel phone, they don't have such feature. So should you buy this device finally or not? Now, first, the pricing. The pricing is exactly same like other phones are offering with the same processor. So there is no such thing like the phone is too much pricey with the underpowered processor. Processor again great. So I'm not seeing much of the drawbacks in this phone. There is a display bleeding issue, which I hope you cannot notice much. And some of the things are going to fix in the software update, like the display stuff and the dual 4G if you're using this kind of big deal. But the battery is just super heavy. I mean, if you're using it as a backup phone or for a media purpose, this is going to give you a great battery backup. Officially IP52, USB Type-C, and the Dolby Atmos sound displays, LTPS, which gives you slightly better sharpness compared to IPS LCD. That's not a problem. Guaranteed software update, which all the Android and phone can give you. There are so many things were there. So if you just find with the drawbacks of the phone that I mentioned here, so it's a good buy. I mean, it is selling like a hot cake, still getting out of stock very soon. So seems like it's a popular device. So anyway guys, that's my full review of the Moto One Power. In case I found something, you know, much serious, definitely I will try to post and re-update video. Till then, this is a good budget device you can really buy and enjoy. So thanks for watching. Have a great day.